Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, what are you willing to surrender to God? Moses answered, what if they do not believe me or listen to me and say, the Lord did not appear to you? Then the Lord said to him, what is that in thine hand? A staff, he replied. The Lord said, throw it on the ground. Moses threw it on the ground and it became a snake, and Moses ran from it. Then the Lord said to him, reach out your hand and take it by the tail. So Moses reached out his hand and took hold of the snake, and it turned back into a staff in his hand. So Moses took his wife and his sons, put them on a donkey, and started back his way to Egypt. And he took the staff of God in his hand. Exodus 4, 1 through 4, and verse 20. What do you have? What is available to you at your disposal, in your possession? This rod was nothing special of itself. It was just a rod, a stick. What was significant about the stick was, it was what Moses had. No, God did not ask Moses what he didn't have. We could all make a long list of things we don't have. We don't have enough money, we don't have a good education, we don't have a good high social standing, and the list goes on and on. God never directs our attention to what we don't have, but to what we do have, even though it seems small. Even though what we have seems small, weak, insignificant, this is on purpose, because God had designed it so that what we have must be connected to Him to work. The difference is the power of God. It is not your ability, your knowledge, your talent, or the size of the gift, or the beauty of your gift that matters. All that matters is how much of God is in your heart. Your heart represents what you have that you're willing to surrender to God. When God gets in it, it will surprise you. Moses fled from the rod when it turned into a serpent. The anointing is the supernatural power of God operating through the natural to produce results that are humanly impossible. We need to ask God to get into our hearts. When God gets in a thing, it's not the same. When God gets in a thing, it can scare some people. Just like Moses, who never seen a rod do anything like this before. God got in a rock and caused a river to flow out of it to quench the thirst of nearly 3 million Israelites. God got in a donkey and caused it to speak to rebuke a rebellious prophet. God got in an axe, the head of iron, and caused it to swim up to the top of the water so that the prophet could reach out his hand and take hold of it. God got in a little pot of oil and caused it to multiply till it met every need and provided an abundant overflow. God got in a box and they called it the Ark of the Covenant. Today, God has chosen to place His presence and His glory in human tents. Our bodies are the temple of God. Scripture reminds us that we have this treasure in earthen vessels. Moses' rod symbolizes something that is weak. It has no life, no energy of its own. It can only do what the natural human power of Moses enables it to do until the power of God got into it. In like fashion, we are weak. We have no life or strength or power of our own. It was only as Moses released his rod to God that the power of God came into it. It is only as we surrender ourselves to God that His power will manifest through us. When Samson was assaulted by the Philistines, there were no superior weapons of quality design to be found. He started looking around for something, anything he could use. He found the jawbone of a donkey and with it slew 1,000 men. What made this jawbone Samson's weapon of choice? The answer is very simple. It was what was there. It was available and it was within reach. God is not looking for greatness. Any old stick, any old bush will do. All God needs is for you to make what you have available to Him. When Samson looked at the jawbone of a donkey, he saw something no one else saw. He saw an instrument of mass destruction, and that's what it became in his hand. Had he despised the jawbone and thought it was too weak or too insignificant or too foolish, he might have died at the hands of the enemy. I believe many of God's people have been defeated in life because we have allowed the enemy to cause us to despise our gift or our talent. Like the servant who went out and buried his one talent, many have buried their talents because it seemed so weak, so small, so insignificant. Look what God did with a stick. The Holy Ghost is saying to you today, it is time to take the harp of the willow tree, dig up the hidden talent, and put it in the Master's hand. My question to you today, what do you have that you're willing to surrender to God? The thought of the day, little is much when God is in it. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.